Hey guys, this is Dion here with Your Guitar Academy, and in this unit, we're going to be learning a really cool Tom Misch style piece that features some lead guitar using an envelope filter. So in this first lesson, I thought it'd be really, really cool to take you through exactly what an envelope filter actually is, what it does, and where you can use it. So grab your guitars and let's get going. If you've just joined us, don't forget you can head straight to the website to get all the additional course materials, including tabs, chord boxes, backing tracks, all entirely free. And also, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We always love to hear how you're getting on with the material. Okay, so we're going to talk all about the envelope filter in this lesson. You know, what it is, how it works, what you can do with it, where to use it, all these different things that you might be curious about. Dan's here to provide some rhythm guitar duties for me.
Of course.
And I think we can kick off by just having a listen to what it sounds like.
Yeah.
So, if we want to play something, let's go for an E major 7 to an A minor 9 or an A minor 7.
Of course.
And I'm going to play first some like lead guitar over the top without the envelope filter, and then we kind of just kick it on.
So without the envelope filter first.
Without it first,
cool.
Yeah.
Slow jam.
Perfect, that sounds good. So to contrast tone, so I guess you're probably on the neck pickup, are you?
I've gone for this middle one.
Okay,
I'm
nice.
I'm not sure why, but if I go like this.
I like that. Nice, nice. So I'm gonna do position two on a Strat because you get a bit more bite to it as opposed to, it's a bit more rounded.
That's
there.
Nice.
It's gonna jump out a bit, all right? So that'll become more apparent when I kick the filter on. So
cool.
Let's give it a go.
Okay, here we go. So.
Fruity note there.
It's nice.
Okay, let's now kick on the filter. You keep going down. There we go, let's stop there.
Why stop there, dude?
I was getting carried away there.
Yeah.
I was getting really carried away. Obviously, like the stuff that I was playing there wasn't like all entirely kind of Tom Misch-esque. It was a little bit more kind of, a little bit busier, I guess, than what Tom would play.
Yeah, for sure.
But I kind of wanted to explain to give you a taste of what the envelope filter does. So as I kicked it on, you could hear that I instantly started playing in a bit more of a kind of percussive way. That's because in essence, really, the envelope filter is just really, really closely related to a wah pedal. Mm-hmm. So it's just essentially just giving us a sort of sweep across a certain frequency. So you get that vocal-like quality to the sound. Mm-hmm. Except obviously, unlike a wah, we're not controlling it with our foot manually.
Yeah.
It's basically set to a certain, level of EQ. You can pick basically which part of the EQ you want to kind of sweep across. So in this case, we've got it set fairly low.
Quite happy to adjust these if you want.
Yeah, so if you move up on the threshold.
Yeah, okay. Should we just put them in the middle?
Put it at noon for now. So it's pretty apparent this, because could you bring the threshold down all the way down to the bottom?
Yeah.
So you see instantly there, it becomes a bit more rounded and a bit more like bassy.
Bassy.
Exactly.
Yeah,
we then put it back all round the other way. It's much more kind of trebly sounding, brighter.
So is it almost like as if I was on a wah, not going all the way up?
Precisely.
Because that's where all the bass is.
Exactly.
And then you go into the treble frequencies.
Exactly. And certain wahs obviously have like a certain frequency sweep, and some of them are adjustable as well. But what I love about the envelope filter is that it removes that thing of having to worry about doing it with your foot. So when it comes to fast passages, you know, that sort of stuff like that, you don't have to go with your foot like crazy. Yeah, you know?
Absolutely.
So you might be thinking, okay, so is it just like an auto wah then? Well, not necessarily, because an auto wah is basically a set rhythm. So it's a set pattern that will remain constant throughout the movement.
Okay.
So with this, it reacts to how we hit the guitar.
Okay.
All right, so, let's put my volume back up. So you hear, if I hit it harder, and it opens up much more. It has more of the kind of, you know, the quality of like your mouth opening, like. It's like, you know, you can hear that sort of brightness as I dig in a bit more.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if I hit it really softly, it's not as much.
No.
Whereas
it's not
hard.
As much.
Exactly. Yeah, that's the kind of sound that we're going for.
Okay.
So that's why it's such a fun and musical pedal to use, that I find. And it really just brings out another side to anyone's playing, I think. So it's a really fun thing to get used to.
It also seems like, when you put it on, I guess it has that vocal quality, right? As you talk about wah, wah.
Exactly,
like
exactly.
And then you play a little differently.
Precisely that, exactly that. And as we've seen through so much of Tom Misch's playing, is he does feature this sort of sound a fair bit. Yeah. It's kind of one of his sort of signatures, I'd say. Yeah. Not every tune, of course, but like he's kind of known for, you know, this vocal quality to his playing.
Yeah.
And it allows you, I find that it allows you to take a simple phrase and just make it sound even cooler almost.
Yeah.
It's definitely a very distinctive sound, and it's one that wouldn't work in every environment, but for this sort of music, it's just absolutely bang on.
Let's take a simple phrase and do that, and maybe do some more upbeat chords with it. And
okay, let's try it. So let's kick off the filter. Maybe something like that, okay?
Okay.
So,
yeah, I like it.
So that's just like a... could go like so if you give me those two chords I have a little go, so if I kick on the filter, here we go.
That's great.
I can't help but go crazy with it. I love it. I just end up going...
Stick to that one thing.
See, one phrase.
I feel like Corey Wong
and
you're Tom Misch, right? I'm just going to give it the big guns.
Yeah, go for it. Now with no filter, here we go. Back
again. Sounds good, but...
Yeah, but now... Two.
That's the business.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just such a cool effect, isn't it? And it sounds, you know, it was popularized way earlier on by, like, you know, guys like Stevie Wonder and such.
Of course,
famous, you know, like Higher Ground, where he's got that sort of clav sound with the envelope opening up.
So
it's just synonymous with this sort of funk genre.
Of course.
And it adds just a certain percussive element and a certain, you know, different feel to the tune that I find.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I just love it. I absolutely adore the envelope filter. So I'd say it's one of those things that every guitarist should really have in their arsenal. I'd say, be it in pedal form like this, or a digital emulation, of which there's so many nowadays.
I mean, I had to search quite far and wide to find this pedal.
Yeah.
I mean, it's obviously available, this MXR envelope filter.
Yeah.
But it's quite an old school pedal.
Mm-hmm.
But there was a good one in Amplitude that
absolutely.
Found when you were recording. Digital ones are absolutely fine. And also, some people like having one of those pedals that just have loads of, you know, for like the choruses, the auto-wahs, the envelope filters, you probably only need them once every now and again.
Totally.
You know what I mean? So it's worth having one of those pedals where it has a few of those
like
options.
Like a multi-modulation thing. Yeah, for sure.
Rather than just like that one pedal. Otherwise, if it was me, the whole album would literally be envelope filter. Just nothing else.
Yeah. It's just, it's an incredibly fun thing to try. And I you can find yourself sitting there for ages just playing, you know. Yeah. And it's one of those things you want to experiment with different, you know, it reacts differently to each pickup as well. So I find that that's right on the neck pickup. Mm-hmm. Obviously, that's then on the setting that I just had it on.
Yeah.
Totally different sounds. You know, the neck pickup's much more rounded,
yeah,
and it reacts differently to that because of the frequency that's going in, you know. Yeah. So it's all, it's just a whole, you know, fun, you know, rabbit hole of experimentation.
So, sure.
Yeah, and it's not, you know, you don't have to just have a wah or an envelope fill. You can have both. You can have an auto wah as well.
That's,
you know,
chaos. That's
they're
chaos.
Kind of their own thing.
Just purely out of interest, does that wah work? Just try and click that bad boy on?
Yeah, I think it does. Yeah.
What does wah and envelope fill to do?
So.
Yeah, I'll turn the envelope fill on.
That's chaos, yeah.
They don't cancel each other out, do they, or anything like that?
No. So, I mean, you can't hear it as much because the wah's much more of an extreme sweep.
Yeah,
you know,
okay,
it's
okay,
much
okay,
more like right from the lows to the highs, where the envelope filter is a bit more of a smaller area of the EQ.
Okay, that's cool.
But they're both, as I say, they both serve their place. You know, it's just, even with gain on as well, I mean. You know, it's just so fun and percussive.
Yeah.
You know, it's really, if you didn't know, I love envelope filters. Can't get enough of them.
I think Tom Misch first turned me onto it. Like, as soon as I heard him do that, is just, I didn't know what that was. Mm-hmm. That's why this is such a good lesson, because probably a lot of people like myself listening to Tom Misch are like, is he just rocking a wah there?
Or what is
happening there? Yeah. And it's literally a pedal that does that for you.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
It's in, remember John Mayer used one in is it Don't Trust Myself as well?
Yes.
That was in that, exactly that intro part there.
Oh, of course.
Which featured that. And it's quite an unmistakable sound that,
like
you say, until you know, it's like,
and then you know it, it's like, yes,
yeah,
need that pedal. In
exactly. Yeah. So there you go. That pretty much just covers what, you know, what is an envelope filter, what to use it for, what it sounds like. And don't forget as well, I mean, I displayed it with like some lead stuff, but you know, you can. All right, so that just about covers everything to do with an envelope filter and what you can use it for, what it sounds like, and all that good stuff. So I'll see you in the next lesson for the first part of the rhythm guitar for this final tune. Thanks a lot for joining us, guys. So if you want to head back to the start of the course, you can click here. And if you want to move on to the next video, you can click here. Also, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment, because we always love to hear how you've got on with the course.